So I was sitting on Martina's lap and, yeah, talking to Billie Jean King. And, yeah, we're watching the Elton John concert. True story, want to hear it?
Yeah!
Okay, I used to do a lot of stuff in my act about how much I love Martina and how I totally worship at the altar of Martina and how I stalked her for like 14 years. And, you know, like a big, huge Martina vein. I just want to lick that vein that sticks out in her forearm, you know what I mean? Just, all right, more information than you needed? Fine. I take you up to the edge, I don't push you over. Okay, so I love her and everything, so I used to do all this stuff in my act about her, so the woman who runs The Advocate, the gay magazine, calls me and she goes, I think it'd be really cool if you did an interview with Martina. And I'm like, sure! So I go to New York and I interview for a couple hours, and she turns to me and she goes, so are you going back to Ohio? And I'm like, yes, I am. She goes, well, you know, do you want to stay over and go to dinner with me and then go out to the Elton John concert with Billie Jean King and some of my friends? Yes! No, sounding too good to be true. And then I realized I had to call my girlfriend. Yeah, tell her I'm not coming home because I'm going out with Martina. Hi, honey. I love you. You're so pretty. Buy you a Lexus. So anyway, my girlfriend has this Lexus, and so I get to stay, and I go out to dinner with Martina and like five of her friends, and her friends had never heard of me. Okay, so I felt really good about myself, and bitter, party of one. So Martina, in order to tell them what I do, she starts, you know, doing some of my jokes, you know, because she has my HBO special on videotape and has, like, memorized it, you know. So apparently this retirement thing is not working out so well. We got to get that girl a hobby. So she starts doing my jokes, you know, and as a comedian, she's an unbelievable tennis player. And then she turns to me and she goes, we don't have a ticket for you, so we're going to go down and pick one up at Madison Square Garden. So we go down to Madison Square Garden and we go up all these back steps. And I think we're going to like the special place where celebrities pick up their tickets, you know. And we're running up all these back steps and all of a sudden, poof, we're in Elton John's dressing room hanging out with Elton John. And I had to pee. You know, the kind of pee that's the center of your universe. You can't hear, you can't think. You have only one focus, you have to go now. Actually, going to the bathroom all night was this huge trauma for me because during this whole long evening, dinner and then the long, long concert and drinks afterwards, every single time I had to go to the bathroom, Martina had to go to the bathroom so she would go with me and be in the stall next to me. And I couldn't pee. And I had to like wait for her to get started. And then rush through mine really quick, you know. Sorry, I have issues. So Elton John, who was very, very sweet to me and very nice, he gives me a ticket. I go down and I'm two rows behind Martina and her friends and one row behind his parents. I mean, I'm talking fabulous seats, right? So I'm sitting in, I'm cozy. Martina turns, she goes, oh, don't sit back there by yourself. Come on down and sit with us. Okay. Seven people, six seats. Seven people, six seats. Say it with me. Seven people, six seats. Excellent. So Martina turns, she goes, oh, okay, you can sit on my lap. I controlled myself. Oh no, I couldn't possibly. She's like, oh, okay, well, you know what? I'll spread my legs. And you can sit in this little spot in between. Now, I want y'all to do that with me right now. Spread your your legs and look at the spot. Just spread your legs. Look at the spot. Do it. Just spread your legs. Good. No, just do it. Just spread your... Do it! Just spread your legs and look at the spot. Right, yeah. Okay. Now look at this. Not exactly a perfect fit. Here, in order not to be, like, too much touching her, I was gripping the edge of that chair with my butt cheeks so hard. Kind of like when you're driving a Volkswagen Beetle, and you go around a corner a little too fast, and you're pretty sure the car's going to tip over, so you clamp down with your ass to hold the car down. So I'm really gripping really hard, okay, and I have my hands on the front railings, and I'm just like, okay, Suzanne, just... Okay, just chill out. Okay, just let it go. Okay, let it go. That's her thighs against your thighs. Just shake it out. Just shake it out. That's cool. Just let it go. Okay, she's starting. Okay, there it goes. Okay, she's moving her thighs with the music, rubbing against your thighs. Her thighs are rubbing against your thighs. Yeah. Okay, now her hand is on your shoulder. Her hand is on your shoulder, and you can feel it. You can feel her breath on your neck, and her hand is on your shoulder, and she's rubbing her thighs against yours, and I love my girlfriend so much. What's her name? Oh, my God, I can't take it anymore. Please don't let her touch me. I can't stand it. I didn't see one fucking second of the concert. I am telling you right now, Elton John could have whacked off on the piano and I'd have been the only one to miss it. People coming up to me for weeks afterwards going, oh wow, Elton John, did he sing Benny and the Jets? I'm like, he might have. My ass still hurts, I don't know. That's all I remember. Okay, so then I'm at home, and I'm writing up the story. The woman from The Advocate calls, she goes, oh, Suzanne, I forgot to tell you, you need to get a quote from a celebrity that knows Martina to start the article, because that's how we do all our interviews. So can you, like, call Katie Lang or Melissa Etheridge? Oh, yeah, because these people are in my Rolodex. Oh, look, right next to Jodie Foster, no problem. I don't know famous people who know Martina. I don't know famous people. And I'm like freaking. And then I remembered that I had met Billie Jean King that night, right? Only it went like this. Suzanne, Billie Jean, Suzanne. She went, hi. And that was all she was having. Right? But a friend who was with her gave me her card, said, hey, when you're in my town, I want to see your show. Give me a call. So I call and I go, look, I know you know Billie Jean King. You got to help me out here. Get a little quote about Martina. Could you just get it? You could just fax it to me. Anything at all. It doesn't really matter. Any little quote about maybe when they... She's like, oh my God, you should call Billie Jean King. She'll really want to talk to you. And I'm remembering the, hi. No, I don't think that'd be a really good idea. I think it'd be a lot better if you just talk to her, just a little anything, you just fax it to me. No, call her, Billie Jean King will really want to talk to her. Call her, she's in Italy. So I call Billie Jean King in Italy, and the bitch talks for an hour and a half. Couldn't say boo to me when I'm sitting next to her for 6 fucking hours. Now I'm calling across the Atlantic and she's like, la 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 la. I'm like, my phone bill came. I was like smoking. It was like. I'll tell you right now, friends and family won't do shit for that. I had to sleep with Candace Bergen. One minute, 2 minutes, 3 minutes. Okay, flash forward, I'm in Chicago. I do 2 shows in Chicago, and I, tell about meeting Martina and everything, going out to dinner with her and all the stuff, Billie Jean King, everything. And I walk off and I go into the dressing room, and who's in the dressing room? Billie Jean King. You know, and hope springs eternal, doesn't it? I'm like, did you just get here? She was like, you were terrific. It was maybe 30 minutes, so I thought you should have her side. That's it. Thank you.